Hello everybody, how are you? Welcome again to our science session. Today, inshallah, we are gonna continue our lesson about solutions. But today, we are we'll try to ask some questions from the lesson review. So let us start with the visual summary of the main ideas that we have learned in this in the previous two lessons. So, for the first question, a solute dissolves in what? A solute dissolves in a solvent. So, remember when we talked about the main parts of solution, and we say that solution is made up of two main parts, solute and solvent. So, a solute will dissolve in a solvent. Next question, a solution in which no more solid can dissolve is what? Is it the diluted solution or concentrated solution or saturated solution? So yes, the answer here will be a saturated solution. Okay, what about question 17? At higher temperature, the solubility of a solid will what? Is it gonna increase or decrease? Guys, what do you think? Well, thank you. Yes, at high temperature, the solubility of salt will increase. Okay, so now let us move to the next slide. And here we need to just make a review for the most important terms that we have learned. We have solvent, solute, concentration, and solubility. So the question is, draw a line to connect the word to its definition. Number one, solvent. Solvent. What is the meaning of solvent, guys? What do you think? The answer will be, okay. So solvent, is it a substance that can be dissolved in another substance? Or is it B, the ability of substance to dissolve in another at a given temperature and pressure? Or the substance in a solution that dissolves the solid? What do you think, guys? Can C be the correct answer? Yes, thank you. So number one, the meaning of solvent is what? The substance in a solution that dissolves the solid. So number one, here the answer will be C. As we say, the solution is made up of two parts, solvent and solute. Solvent is the substance in a solution that dissolves the solute. What about solute? Yes, number two, the answer will be A. Solute is a substance that can be dissolved in another substance. Okay, so now let us move to three. Concentration, guys, what do you think? Concentration, the definition of concentration, it would be either B or D. So what do you think? Concentration, yes, concentration is a measure of the amount of substance dissolved in another substance. It's the amount of solute in a given amount of solvent. So number three, the answer will be D. And then we'll have question four. Solubility. Solubility, guys, is the ability of substance to dissolve in another at a given temperature and pressure. So number four, the answer will be B. Okay. All right. Okay. So here's the answer, guys. Now let us move to the next question. Question number five says, in a solution of water and salt, which substance is the solute and which substance will be the solvent? Okay, so the solute, as we say, it is the part that will dissolve in another substance. Which substance will dissolve? Is it the water or salt, guys? Okay, yes, so salt is our solute here in this solution, while water is the solvent. Okay, so the answer, guys, will be what? Will be following. Salt is the solute, and water is the solvent. And of course, the solvent could be something else, but we usually use water as solvent in most of solutions. So salt is the solute and water is the solvent. Okay. Okay. So now, guys, let's move to the next question. And here, question number six. Question number six says, how does pressure affect the solubility of what or gases? So we know that we have two main factors that will affect the solubility: pressure and temperature. And guys, as we said, pressure will not affect solubility of solid or liquid, but it will affect and it will change the solubility of gases. So how does pressure affect the solubility of gases? What do you think the answer will be here, guys? Well, yes, so guys, as the pressure increases, the solubility of gases will decrease. As the pressure decreases, the solubility of gases will increase. So guys, the answer for this question will be, the solubility of gases increases at high pressure and decreases at lower pressure. So now let us move to question number six. How does pressure affect the solubility of gases? Remember, guys, we say that we have two main factors that will affect the solubility: the pressure and the temperature. And we say that pressure will not affect the solubility of solids and liquids, but it will affect the solubility of gases. And we say that as the pressure increases, solubility of gases will increase, and as pressure decreases, the solubility of gases will decrease. So the answer, guys, will be, the solubility of gases increases at high pressure and decreases at lower pressure. So question number eight, which would dissolve sugar faster, hot tea or iced tea? And explain your answer. So I all will answer that hot tea would dissolve sugar faster. But why, guys? Can you explain why the sugar will dissolve faster in hot tea? What do you think, guys? So yes, cause heating a solution causes all the particles to move around faster. The particles will move around more quickly. This movement allows better separation of the solid particles, so they are more easily dissolved by the solvent. So guys, here is the answer. Hot tea will dissolve sugar faster. Why? Cause heating a solution causes all the particles to move around more quickly. This movement allows better separation of the solid particles, so they are more easily dissolved by the solvent. So now, here we have this table, and we are going to use this table to answer question number 9 and 10 and 11. And actually, in the previous lesson, we answered question number 9, if you remember. So guys, here we have this table. In this table, we have three solid solids. We have sodium chloride, potassium nitrate, and sodium sulfate. And we have the solubility of each of these solute at two different temperatures, at 25 and 100 centigrade. And the questions, to answer the questions, we should analyze the data here in this table. So for question number 9, we have already answered question number 9, guys. You may refer to the answer in the previous lesson. Anyway, we're gonna discuss it again. How does an increase in temperature affect the solubility of each compound in 100 gram H2O or water? Okay, so again, the increase in temperature. How? The increase in temperature affects the solubility of sodium chloride, potassium nitrate, and sodium sulfate. Guys, as we can see here, the low temperature, the solubility of sodium chloride and potassium nitrate was low. For sodium chloride, for example, it was 36 and 39 for potassium nitrate, but as we increase the temperature to 100 centigrade, the solubility, as you can see, increased. Okay, but for the third solid, which is sodium sulfate, you can see that the solubility of this solid decreased as we raised the temperature. Okay, so now let's move to the next question. Question number 10. So question number 10 says, how can you influence the rate at which the solids dissolve in 100 gram H2O at either temperature? Guys, the question here is how to influence, or how to, for example, increase the solubility of these solids, but without changing what? Without changing their temperature or their pressure. Okay, guys. Actually, we discussed about temperature and pressure as the main factors that would affect the solubility, but we have other methods that can also influence the solubility of solid. So, for example, guys, if you want to increase the solubility of sugar in a cup of tea, what usually you do? Yes, thank you. Stirring, guys. Stirring is a way, and the simple way that we can, what, in which we can increase the solubility of sugar or any solid. So the main, the first method will be by stirring. The second way, guys, let's think more about it. Okay, well done. So yes, crushing solute will, what, will increase the solubility of the solid. So if you crush the sugar to a fine particles, they will dissolve faster. So stirring and stirring the solute and the crushing solute will increase its solubility. So guys, here's the answer. We can increase the solubility by stirring or crushing the solid. So guys, for the last question, suppose the temperature was lower to 18 degrees Celsius. How do you think this would affect the solubility of each solid? So let us go back to that table. So guys, for the first two solids, we say that as the temperature increase, the solubility will increase, but for the third solute, as the temperature increase, the solubility will decrease. So lowering the temperature to 18 degrees Celsius for the first two solute will decrease their solubility, right? Why lowering the temperature for the third temperature for the third solute, which is sodium sulfate, will increase its solubility. So guys, here's the answer. Lowering the temperature will decrease the solubility of the first two solutes, but it might increase the solubility of the third solute. So guys, that's all for today. Thank you, and see you inshallah tomorrow with a new lesson.